That's right, the deadline is looming for Minnesota lawmakers tonight.
So we're looking at what's done, what's left to do, and what's not getting finished. The clock is running down now. There are just 6 hours until the legislative deadline hits at midnight tonight. So we have crews live, ready to bring you the decisions that affect the lives of homeowners, families, and businesses statewide.
But first, let's go to 5 Eyewitness News political reporter Tom Hauser. He's been at the Capitol all weekend long, right along with lawmakers. Tom?
And Bill, as you guys mentioned, the clock is ticking, but so far today, very little progress on the remaining key budget bills. But in mid-afternoon today, there was a huge blow-up over a controversial bill that would allow home daycare and home health care workers to unionize. Now, supporters and opponents, as we were showing you all weekend, have been standing vigil outside the House chambers since Saturday. Today, the bill passed the House by a narrow 68-66 margin. It sparked celebration inside the House gallery where observers are supposed to remain silent. That drew an angry reaction from Republicans.
Yeah, Mr. Speaker, Mr. Speaker. Yeah, Mr. Speaker. Yes.
Mr. Speaker.
Yes, go ahead and applaud. That's right. Go ahead and let him applaud. Mr. Speaker.
Stop. Stop.
Let him applaud.
Mr. Speaker. Clear the deck, Mr. Speaker.
We're not in charge, but let him applaud. They own the place.
And of course, that last reference was to the notion that Democrats are supported largely by unions, and Democrats control the House, Senate, and governor's office. Governor Dayton will get that bill sometime in the next couple of days, and he is very likely to sign it. So again, that was very controversial. Meanwhile, there is still a to-do list that they have to work on here in the last 6 hours of the session. The biggest bit of unfinished business is for the Senate to pass the tax bill. It raises $2 billion in tax revenue, mostly from upper-income Minnesotans, and by more than doubling the cigarette tax. Now, using some of that cigarette tax money to finance the Viking Stadium got a lot of attention early this morning when the House passed the tax bill.
You know, rather than Robin Hood, take from the rich and give to the poor, with this tax and using it in the way that we are, okay, rather than for health care costs, but to fund a Viking Stadium, we're taking from the poor and giving to the rich.
And now there are just under 6 hours left in this regular session of the 2013 legislature. We will be here throughout the night with all the latest developments. Live at the state capitol, Tom Hauser, 5 Eyewitness News.
We've also been looking into another little-known part of the budget. It's buried in the sales tax proposal. Governor Dayton expanded items subject to the 6.5% sales tax to include custom software, equipment and repair maintenance, and warehouse storage. Critics of the tax worry that businesses would move their inventories and jobs to other states like Wisconsin, Iowa, or North Dakota, states that don't impose sales tax on warehouse services. 3M, General Mills, Target, and Best Buy use storage services here in Minnesota. If the tax sticks, Minnesota would be the only state in the country to tax warehousing services. Now let's turn to what is not getting the green light. A lot of organizations and projects in need are on this list, leaving many people disappointed tonight. 5 Eyewitness News reporter Naomi Peskovitz is live at the Walker Art Center in Minneapolis. This is an area that had requested money for the popular sculpture garden, Naomi.
Leah, the Walker had asked for $7 million as a part of that original bonding bill that got the axe on Friday. And a lot of that money would have gone to the area where we are standing now, the famous Spoon and Cherry. It would have gone to help fix the pond surrounding it, help fix up a lot of the trees that you see around us, and some of the area that you can't see, the irrigation under our feet. Now, the Walker didn't get the funding that it wanted, and the Walker isn't alone either. Even on a rainy day, the Minnesota Zoo draws a fun crowd. We found 5.5-year-old Julia Clissell oogling over the snow monkeys, who she thinks love Minnesota.
Because a lot of times it's sunny.
But what director and CEO Lee Emke says the snow monkeys would really love is a step up from their current habitat dating back to 1978.
Getting them out of a pit and bringing them up to eye level and really creating a state-of-the-art exhibit for those guys is a very top priority for us.
It's a priority that will have to wait, along with renovations to Discovery Bay. Emke gave us a tour of the construction, which started with last year's bonding money, but will likely halt in November.
But at this point, it looks like we'll just stop the work. We'll, you know, shut everything down until we can go back next year with another request.
Lawmakers also shot down requests from three of the state's convention centers. While the one here in Minneapolis hosts hundreds of events a year, centers in St. Cloud, Mankato, and Rochester won't get the money they wanted.
And while Walker's Sculpture Garden celebrates 25 years this summer, their request was also on the cut list. But like the zoo, they say they'll ask again.
Such an important state icon. It needs to be refurbished, and we're committed to continuing and soldiering on.
And very early this morning, the Senate did pass a very small portion of the bonding bill that would help renovate the state capitol, but it still has to pass in the House, and there isn't very much time left before the deadline at midnight tonight. Reporting live in Minneapolis, Naomi Peskovitz, 5 Eyewitness News.
In other developments at the Capitol, lawmakers voted to make all-day kindergarten a reality. Starting next year, some 60,000 kids will get the chance to attend free all-day kindergarten. It's part of a $15.7 billion education package approved by state lawmakers yesterday. The education bill also freezes tuition at public universities across the state for the next 2 years. Today, the Senate also voted to put a proposed change to the state constitution on the ballot in 2016. Voters will decide whether to let an independent board set legislators pay. Sponsors say the change will remove a conflict of interest and take a politically charged matter out of the Capitol. And supporters of legislation meant to crack down on bullying in schools are vowing to press on next year after the Senate tabled that bill. Supporters of the measure rallied at the Capitol today. The bill requires all public school districts to create an anti-bullying policy or risk losing state aid. Senate put the bill on hold after Republicans vowed to mount a 10-hour debate against that measure.
You know, I think this is a big mistake on the part of the Republicans. It's very cynical and it's really sad. I think they just have been irresponsible and have turned their backs on kids in Minnesota.
Senator Dibble assured supporters the bill will be reintroduced next February. We'll be tracking decisions at the Capitol all night long tonight. Remember, the deadline's midnight. We'll be ready to bring you news on votes that affect you and your family. Stay with 5 Eyewitness News for breaking updates and watch for more online at KSTP.com.